Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to receive payments in QuickBooks Online. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also click this link to access our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. If you created an invoice in QuickBooks Online to record a sale to a customer, at some point you expect to receive payment from your customer for that invoice. Receiving payments is only necessary if you have an open invoice to apply the payment to. If you receive a payment from a customer and you have not created an invoice in QuickBooks, then proceed to the sales receipt lesson to enter this payment. You can access this lesson by clicking this link. Receiving payments in QuickBooks Online helps maintain an accurate accounts receivable balance. Refer to the text part of this lesson to learn more about how a payment affects the accounts and financial statements in QuickBooks. You must receive payments in QuickBooks so that they are applied to the correct invoices. This will ensure that your accounts receivable balance is accurate. One of the most common mistakes made when checks are received from customers is that they are entered into QuickBooks as a deposit. Entering checks received as payment for an invoice as a deposit is a mistake because the outstanding invoice will remain unpaid in QuickBooks. The amount owed by the customer, also known as the accounts receivable, will be overstated. Sales will be overstated because it was recorded when the invoice was created and then again when the deposit was entered. The account used to record the deposit transaction may not be correct. If you follow these steps, you can minimize these type of issues. First, when a check is received from a customer, check to see if the customer has any open invoices. If so, then follow the steps outlined in this course for receiving payment. If the customer does not have any open invoices, then follow the steps in the sales receipt lesson to record this payment. To access this course, click this link. For the purposes of this video, we will use a fictitious company called Paul's Plumbing. As you view this video, think about how the information might differ for your business. To begin, after you sign into your QuickBooks Online account, click on the plus sign located at the very top of the home page and select Receive Payment. The Receive Payment window should display on your screen. We will complete these fields for our fictitious company, Paul's Plumbing. The first field is the customer name. You want to select the customer's name from the dropdown. If you have not set up the customer information yet, then this customer does not have any outstanding invoices in QuickBooks. Do not proceed with receiving this payment. Close out of this window immediately and follow the steps in the sales receipt lesson to record this payment. To access this course, click this link. Payment date. The payment date should be the date that you receive the payment. This date does not impact financial statements, so if you don't know the exact date that you received the payment, it is okay to make your best guess here. You can also keep the envelope that the checks come in so that you can use the postmark date as your payment date. Payment method. You want to select the payment method from the drop-down list. The options are cash, check, and credit card. If you have an Intuit Payments account, go ahead and select credit card for the payment method and enter your customer's credit card information in the next screen. Once you click the Save button, QuickBooks will process the credit card payment and a message will display on the screen to inform you whether the credit card payment was accepted or declined. Reference number. If your customer paid by check, you want to enter the check number into this field. Otherwise, you can just enter any information here that will help you reference the payment later on. The deposit to field is the bank account where you will deposit this payment to. So you want to go ahead and make that selection here. The amount received will automatically populate once you select the invoice that this payment applies to. So for the outstanding invoices that we have here, you want to select, put a check mark in the first column to select the invoice that the payment is for, and then the amount received field will populate with that invoice amount. Once you are satisfied with everything on this screen, we'll go ahead and save this transaction and close out of this window. And then let's go back to the customer center so we can take a look at the transactions that we just entered for our customer Aaron here. So the first thing we'll see is the payment that we entered on this first row. So you will notice that this invoice has a paid status now. And if we take a look at the invoice, it also shows paid in the upper right-hand corner. And that wraps up the lesson on how to receive payments in QuickBooks Online. To access our full QuickBooks Online course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.